Iliza Schlesinger! When you list it all like that, it does sound rather depressing. Why do we do it?
It feels depressing and exhausting.
Have you ever thought about just not doing it? We can just not do it together.
Yeah, I think about a lot of things that I don't do. Like write a will. Don't tell that last thing. To do these things. Yeah, something.
Well, a lot of your comedy and your Netflix specials have talked about the pressure that is placed upon women.
Yeah.
And especially maybe when you have a wedding and become a bride. You actually got married a couple of years ago.
Did
you have a traditional ceremony?
You.
Yes.
Wow.
Hold on.
That's me.
Beautiful.
Thank you so much. I was traditional. I just remember thinking, you know, nobody really wants to hear your vows for an hour, and nobody wants to hear about the Bible. And so I was like, I had like a time. I had like a light. I was like, let's get it done. It was like 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. We each read our own vows, and like it was out of there. Because you want to get to the drinking, which is why you attend any of them. But, you know, you keep it a little classy, a little traditional, and then you just go to town.
So what's one tradition that you loved, actually, that you really kind of got into in the moment, you felt it?
I cried, which is a tradition for women for everything. there were a lot of things. In my last special, I talk about, like, I didn't do a garter, because, like, no woman's thigh has ever looked thin with a garter. It's always like, oh, look, a Christmas ham with a belt on it. And I didn't do a veil over the face, because I think it's, like, a little creepy. No offense if you did it, like, that's your choice, but it looks weird. I just think a lot of those things are designed, like, you have a finite amount of time to party and to, like, do stuff, and I didn't want to take up time with all that stuff.
So while we're talking established traditions,
yes.
Have you done Galentine's Day?
No. And why do we talk about this every year? Why is this?
We don't. I've never heard
of this. Everybody talks about this. Here's the deal.
Oh, okay?
I'm going to throw a grenade in the whole segment.
Yeah.
If you have a Valentine, it's tacky. It's tacky to do it. You're going to get upcharged at restaurants. And if you're just a girl and you're single, then it's okay to not even acknowledge the holiday, as we do most imposed holidays, right?
Yeah.
You don't have to grab your girlfriend and, like, link arms and go out kicking in dicks. You can just... Put a face mask on, go to bed. Take an Ambien. You guys don't have that in this country, but, like, be done with it.
Really appreciate you not kicking in dicks, by the way.
It doesn't have to be a thing, because all the girls are like, I hate it so much, but then you get a Valentine, it's like, I like it. So the pendulum continues to swing.
Last time you came here, I understand you got held up at customs because you, like, declared lollies from Mexico or something. How did you go this time?
That sounds like drugs.
I didn't say that, but sure.
It was a bag of Mexican candy I brought from L.A. for a friend of mine who lives here. We were doing, like, an international candy exchange.
That sounds more like drugs.
It was drugs. It was ecstasy. So we're just bringing different drugs from different countries. And I declared it because I was trying to be a good traveling citizen. And, you get stuck behind people who are like, oh, it's a live fish, but I thought it would be okay because it's not dead. And so, but even on the way over here, because of coronavirus, I had to cancel 3 dates in Southeast Asia that I was doing after Australia. And when you're on the plane, they say, if you have coughing or if you have a fever or anything, please notify a cabin crew member. And there was a woman over my shoulder who was coughing. And you turn on mankind so quickly. I was like, her! Send someone! Get her! She was just choking on like a cracker. Like, you can never be too safe.
We understand you've shot a sketch show. It hasn't been broadcast yet, but we believe there's an Australian character. Is that correct?
Yes, it's the Iliza Schlesinger sketch show. It is, if you go to Netflix, there's a place card for it, but it comes out this spring. And there's one character, her name's Kit Wazzle. Kit Wazzle, and she's, I just got so nervous. Kit Wazzle, she's a Cole Kidman stunt double. and she's got the acting bug. So we follow her around on auditions, and... it's like a firing squad. Like, I'm so nervous because it sounded like a little British. And you're like, oh,
I think it's the last accent you can get away with, to be honest, the Australian accent. But where did you learn it? Have you studied tapes of any Australian TV or?
I do love Kath and Kim. But I have a very good friend named Waz. Shout out to Waz if he's watching. And he's Australian, so I had him read the script to make sure it sounded authentic. And then I showed him the sketch when I was done, wanting some like Aussie praise, and he was like, yeah, you done good. So we'll see. I think
Kit
it's okay.
Kit Wazzle.
Kit Wazzle. Stunt woman for hire.
Well, details of where you can catch Iliza in Australia on her forever tour are on our website. Would you please thank Iliza Schlesinger?